the opposite way you should be thinking. You should be proud of what you do, and you should be proud of the good information that you've been disseminating for, I mean, at least a decade as far as I'm concerned. And I've been at this now in this world for almost 15 years right now, telling the truth. And I think net-net, we have helped people in many ways, not just regarding precious metals. But I'll say, you know, we're speaking today, and look, this is just, I mean, we're getting to the point now, I call these named storm attacks, you know, like the Leap Day violation, yeah, or the Sunday Night Paper Silver Massacre, when it's just all out. You know, the difference between now and those a couple of years ago were that there's absolutely no reason. There's not even a propaganda meme of why, like, oh, gold is smashed because the Fed's going to raise rates or something. There isn't even a such thing as negative news for precious metals anymore. The fact is, just like back in 2011 in May, China is closed for the week. The fact is that Miles Franklin, I can guarantee you, not a single person has called us all day or will dream of calling us all day to sell anything. To the contrary, every major, except for the top in 2001, every major demand surge we've had has been after these cartel hits. And to put it, you know, one step further, you know, the word, why are we doing this call today, which was fortuitously timed, the word is empowerment. And when I think about when I started back in 2002, I was just writing about it. It was May 2002. I bought my first shares of Newmont Mining. It wasn't more than a few weeks later where there was the first big smash, and I was sitting there thinking to myself, what did I do wrong? Did I miss something? And, you know, GATA was there for me. I listened to read Bill Murphy every day, Jim Sinclair, Richard Russell. And they helped to empower me to understand the fraud and the manipulation so that in time I was able to teach myself, A, how to best protect myself, and B, not to succumb to the fear, to the propaganda. And now more than ever, you know, the reason we're seeing, basically since the Brexit, we're seeing the level of suppression more than anything I've ever seen combined because of the fear that the end game is here. The world is falling apart politically, economically, monetarily, socially, and as a result, there's a desperation to remain in power by the powers that be that is simply failing. The Brexit was the start of it. A Donald Trump victory will be a Brexit times 10, and it's not just here, it's everywhere. You're going to see the Spanish, there's no government in Spain. You're going to see the Italian prime minister resign. Holland and France said he won't run for re-election if the unemployment rate soars, which it has. Merkel's done over there. You know, Greece, we're going to have a Brexit soon. They're rioting in the streets again. Look what's going on in Turkey and Brazil, all these places around the world. So again, if you own physical metal, you're just doing fine so long as you don't bite on margin. And, you know, I think this should just serve as a clarion call for people to realize that, you know, the paper world is a very dangerous one because it's so manipulated, and you need to be very careful what you own.
So I think everybody also, you know, you consider that central banks essentially are running the show right now. And a day like today is a good reminder. And I feel upset about, you know, the way the mining shares are reacting today, the way the physical precious metals are reacting today, because I know that the people who are buying these things, I know they're right. I just don't know if they have the stomach to be right. And it's days like this where people always look to why, like you said, is it an interest rate? Is it what is it? You know, no matter what happens, we have a very controversial election. No matter who wins, 50% of the country is going to be very, very upset. The world may be upset if Trump wins because of what's going on with the oligarchs. But if Hillary wins, you're going to have 50% of the country running to gun stores and bullion dealers because they're going to prepare for essentially the end game. And then you've got Italy, as you noted, is going to do their vote on a possible their Brexit or Italian leave or whatever they're calling it. But, you know, on a day like today, you know, when it's down big, I hope people listening to the show realize that just logically, there's no reason for it to be down when all this stuff's boiling over. So just realize that there are nefarious forces out there trying to shake people out, trying to prevent people from owning these things, from owning real precious metals, real physical assets. When major indexes, I mean, they could implode at any time, and they're already being propped up by central banks, which are just another form of bailout. Andy, I don't want to ramble on here. So just for people today, you know, what should they be looking at when they're looking for news? Like you said, there really is no news. Today is essentially, maybe this week might be a great time to add to their positions. As well as, there are some things I think that are catalysts that, people should consider, like Deutsche Bank. You know, I've gotten some emails from subscribers that are worried that Deutsche Bank is going to be like Lehman Brothers. But maybe you could dissect that for us and give us your analysis why Deutsche Bank could be much worse than Lehman Brothers.
Well, yeah, of course you should be buying physical metal today. I mean, this is a gift from heaven. I mean, look, the price of gold was silver was $19.70 2 days ago. I mean, on Friday morning, and now it's $17.75. I mean, that's a 10% drop in two trading days for nothing. And again, you know, the news, everyone's looking, going, you know, Zero Hedge puts this article, ECB shocks everyone by saying that they would taper the QE before they end it. And then you look at it and go, no, they didn't say they're ending it. They didn't even say how or why. They just said, yeah, if and when we decide to end it, we would taper it. I mean, that's not even news. And then they go, oh, the euro, it surged on that news, as if that matters. But it surged and then it plunged. I mean, there's no news there with Deutsche Bank. Oh my God, Deutsche Bank is talking about they're going to have a settlement at the end of the year. Well, no, they're actually not talking about a settlement. That was disproven. In fact, that stick save that they had on Friday by making up that rumor only brought in the Italian prime minister to sue Deutsche Bank for defrauding them because he's trying to scapegoat Deutsche Bank for the problems at his own banks, at Bank Montepaschi specifically. So again, no, you're not going to find anything in the news. There's no meme change. Nothing is going on. And, you know, I see Zero Hedge goes, oh, and, you know, the dollar is surging because of rate hike odds are surging. And go, the dollar's not surging. There's nothing going on here with the dollar that's out of the ordinary. Not that the dollar has any real correlation to gold anyway, the dollar index. It never did, and it doesn't now. So again, don't get too excited about anything. Use this smash as the time to start protecting yourself. Be lucky that if you haven't started it, because you could do so now. I mean, remember last July, there was a Sunday night in July. I remember it well. I had just gone to the Dragon Boat Festival, and it was a nice day. I was watching the Mets in the 20th inning of their game. And then in a matter of, I think it was 10 minutes on a Sunday night, gold was hit for $52 an ounce. Thinly traded, China closed, and you know it marked the bottom. So whatever the reason is, if they're scared about something coming, who knows what it is, just use this opportunity to protect yourself, because every time we've had smashes like this, the supply has dried up, the premiums have exploded, and you know, when you're talking about Deutsche Bank, you know, people are emailing you worried that it's going to be the next Lehman. It is the next Lehman. I mean, we're worried that it's going to be. I was just telling someone this morning, you don't need to be a conspiracy theorist or you know, a gold guru to look at what Deutsche Bank has done all year, the stock has done all year, to see that it's dead. That's why I wrote this back in the middle of June, that it was dead, and it's far worse now. They are going to go. Why they have been selected as opposed to all the other banks that, you know, many of them are in just as bad shape, I don't know, but they look like they're going to be the first to go. And, you know, it's just a matter of time. And if they're not the first to go, well, someone else just like them will go, or something else will occur. Because, you know, I wrote yesterday about, you know, mark this day, war has begun. The governments are turning on each other monetarily. Now look, militarily even, we're threatening Russia with military operations. What are we, crazy? I mean, so many bad things are happening as a result of 40 years of money printing and financial repression, that the ramifications are here. They're irreversible. And as I said, you know, a few months ago, you will literally not see a positive news item about economics or politics anytime in the coming future. You just won't. They'll be absolutely all negative.
Andy, what are your thoughts on the Norwegian Central Bank and the Swiss Central Bank disclosing the SEC that they had to, or that they did purchase about 25 mining shares each? Do you think that this recent pullback is another thing that's just staged because central banks want to own physical gold, want to own gold mines, and essentially they're just using this as an opportunity to hoard more gold mines and gold for themselves?
No, I mean, I think the Swiss bank and the Bank of Japan, they're just buying shares in general because they've run out of things to QE. There's no, you can't buy the, I mean, the Swiss can't buy bonds because the entire Swiss yield curve is negative out to like 30 or 40 years. So now they're buying stocks. And, you know, if you're buying stocks, you know, you buy a little of everything. They have probably the biggest position in Apple because, well, Apple's the biggest stock. My guess is just simple portfolio management. And I don't really think, look, when it comes to mining shares, when the end game hits, the governments of those countries where the mines are going to take the mines. And either way, the ownership percentage of mines by the Swiss National Bank is nothing compared to their ownership of stocks in general or the Bank of Japan. So, I mean, I guess you could take it as a positive that they're buying instead of selling, but I think it's more a matter of banks are just central banks right now are just so desperate to prop things up. They're just buying everything they can. You know, that's what QE to infinity is. At some point, the Fed will have to overtly join in what they're clearly covertly doing. You know, at some point, I called the end game of communism. These central banks are going to wind up owning every stock and every bond and every piece of real estate to the point where it's true communism. And that's why you protect yourself now, especially in days like today, by owning assets that are outside of the system so that they can't control them.
Well, seriously, I mean, the Dow would be at 3,000 if central banks weren't buying stocks on the public markets, and with all their bond initiatives, as well as, you know, ZIRP and negative interest rates on some central banks. Andy, with when it comes to precious metal ownership, just in closing, on a day like today, I know Miles Franklin, you guys are probably getting calls for people to purchase precious metals. What is the best deal out there if somebody wants to own a gold coin or a silver coin? Because I do get that question a lot. You know, people, I'm sure you guys get it even more. Bullion versus American Eagle. I mean, right now, with let's just looking at premiums, what's the best deal out there?
Well, they're both historically undervalued, and you know, fortunately, the premiums have been relatively low recently. I think you had a lot of people during the summer doldrums. They got excited about Brexit, and then when the prices really flatlined, I mean, until this week, they haven't gone down. They just kind of been flatlining. People just kind of lost interest, and so the premiums have been relatively low for both. You know, that said, now you know you see the gold silver ratio is obviously surging again, so it's going to bring a lot of people into silver. It always does. Every time we have these crashes, silver goes down more and the demand for silver picks up more. But generally speaking, you know, forget what's going on today. Everyone should realize that if you're starting a precious metal portfolio, the best way to start is to do the way I have always done it. You start in your mind, I'm going to be half gold and half silver. I mean, yes, silver, it has some things that are more favorable than gold, you know, because it's cheaper and you can buy more of it. On the other hand, it's more volatile and it scares people more. So, you know, you start in your mind, I'm going to own half and half. And you generally want to own 1 ounce coins. It's that simple. It's all I own. It's probably 99% of Miles Franklin sales. You don't want to get bigger bars because it's a little cheaper, because A, it's not much cheaper, and B, it's a lot less liquid. So when you do want to sell it, you want to get the best price. So I would say if you're starting a portfolio, I would go half gold, half silver. I'd stick to the most liquid coins like the Eagles, the Maples, you know, whatever the best deal you could find is. And you'll do just fine, because when you do need to sell it, if you need to sell it, you're going to have no problem doing so, and you're going to get the best available price.